Today we're going to talk about how to set up your rMotion rear suspension, basically how to get the sled dynamics right for your riding style. Let's discuss the rMotion rear suspension. You've got what is the industry's benchmark for comfort and capability now. So how do you adjust it to tailor it to fit your style and your ride? We're going to go over some of those concepts, and when we're all done, you'll have a really good grasp of how to adjust your suspension to fit your needs. If you ordered in the springtime and got the quick adjust option, you've got spring preload on your left running board. On the right-hand side, you've got shock compression adjustment. Both very easy to get at, so it makes it kind of simple that way. All of them will have the coupling block adjustment here that controls the weight transfer back and forth on the snowmobile. And also, you've got two positions for the shock, the rear shock. By moving it up, you lose about 20% of the compression damping in it, so you soften up the ride by about 20%. Limiter strap, also adjustable here. And then this front, the center shock, the preload adjustment on that one. So that gives you an idea of some of the adjustments that are available on the rMotion to tailor it to the way you want it to ride. Okay, so you're familiar with some of the adjustments that are available in the components of the suspension. So let's talk about some of the first steps in adjusting your ride. One of the first things you want to do is measure the sag that is in the suspension. Okay, for your weight and your style, that's going to be very important. What I'm going to do first of all is take and lift up the suspension like this, get all the free play out of the suspension so it's fully extended. Okay, and we're going to measure right back here where the mud flap and the bumper meets, where I'm going to choose to measure at. And right now I'm at 22 1/4 inches right there. All right, now the rider gets on here and we're going to see the difference between the amount of sag that there is in the suspension with the rider on it versus the free height, the fully extended height. So rider. All right, now we're going to measure it again. And we're at 17 1/4 inches. So as you can see, we've collapsed the suspension quite a bit. The general guideline is between 2 and 3 inches for an rMotion. Some guys even run a little bit less, maybe an inch, inch and a half, depending on what you want for a preload. But you want some movement for sure. You definitely want it to move. So right now, with Tyler, our test rider on here, who's had a few too many cheeseburgers this week, we're going to have to turn up the preload to get a good ride for him. We have our suspension set at position number 1 on the quick adjust. As you can see, we had 5 inches of sag with Tyler on it. So we need to turn the machine up, or turn the spring up. We'll try 2 1/2 for Tyler. Okay, we've made an adjustment to the spring preload for our rider's weight. So we're gonna check it one more time to make sure we've got our maximum free length. Yep, we're still at 22 1/4. Then we have our rider step on. We'll see if we made a difference in the sag of the suspension. All right, we measure it again from the same exact spot, and we find out we're at about 19 1/4 inches, 19 1/2 inches, somewhere in there. So we're within that window of 2 to 3 inches. Now remember, there's a lot of things that make a difference with this. The amount of friction in the track, how tight the track is, can all have an effect on how you measure sag and how easy it is for the suspension to collapse. So keep those things in mind. A well-worn, well-used track broken in gives you much more sag, much more freedom of movement back and forth, along with a loose track. A tight one won't move as much. Okay, for those of you that don't have the quick adjust on your rMotion, we've got two differences here. You're gonna adjust the spring on the cam down here, and then you also have the clicker for the shock right on the piggyback or right on the shock body itself. We've got the measurement that we were looking for. We've got the right amount of sag. We're between that magic 2 and 3 inches for an rMotion suspension. So that was step one. Now let's move on to step two. We'll get this machine to perform exactly as the rider wants it to. The next adjustment we're going to look at, step two, is the coupling block right here. Okay, a very active rider will probably want to leave that on position number 1. Somebody that moves around a lot on the snowmobile, because it will lift the skis easily when they want them to as they move their weight back. And as they come forward on the snowmobile, it will transfer weight back onto the skis for cornering. Now, if you want more ski pressure, you want more positive turning, probably one of the easiest adjustments you can make is to turn this position to number 2 or 3. Okay, to adjust it, you simply push in on this button, turn it to the desired position, and you'll feel it lock into place there. Make sure you do both sides. You have to adjust both coupling blocks to the same position. Okay, so turn your coupling blocks to position 2 or 3, or maybe even as far as 4, to keep your skis planted in turns and when under acceleration. another one of the most common asked questions is, how do I make my sled steer more positively? So now this has got a lot to do with riding styles too, so keep in mind whether you move around a lot on the seat or not. But the number one thing you want to try first is the coupling block. Okay, if you haven't tried it in positions 2, 3, and 4, make sure you try that. Okay, if that doesn't suit your style, another thing you consider is going back to, say, position 1 or 2, wherever you're most comfortable at, and turning up your spring preload. Now keep in mind, spring preload is meant for your weight, but it also controls the attitude of the chassis a little bit. So maybe 3 inches of sag was too much for you, and you want 1.5 inches of sag. Keep that in mind. That's another option to consider for that. And then finally, if none of those seem to really be working for you, you can also try shortening up the limiter strap on the front of the vehicle. That's a last resort because that does take away suspension travel. It's not something we highly recommend for most people because you usually solve the problem with the first 2 adjustments really quickly and really easily. If you have an X or an XRS, you've got adjustable damping on your rear shock. So it has 22 clicks. You want to start about in the middle at position number 10 or 11 and then ride the vehicle. See how it works for you. Don't be afraid to change it back and forth. It's very, very easy. Obviously, it's just a click or two away. I recommend you make 2 click adjustments at a time so that then you can see a difference quicker as to whether you're going the right direction or the wrong direction for what it is you're looking for in a ride. Turning it in obviously makes it harder. Turning it out to the left counterclockwise makes it softer. For those of you that don't have the quick adjust on your rMotion, you also have the clicker for the shock right on the piggyback or right on the shock body itself.